One of the boys who lived in the town around the bend when I was growing up had kind of a funny name. His name was Bucket of Beans. Funny name for a kid, but he didn't seem to mind it much because it made everybody laugh, at least the first time, and he liked to see people laugh. Of course, after the sixth or seventh time of saying his name, it stopped being funny and was just his name, which is the way it is with most everything, even if your name is Horse Noodle or Wingnut. Bucket of Beans had a sister whose name was Clarisse, which just goes to show you that not everyone in the family had funny names, unless you think Clarisse is a funny name. But then maybe if you did, Bucket of Beans wouldn't be very funny, or you'd just have to say it six or seven times and it would stop being funny. Anyway, something interesting was always happening to Bucket of Beans, and you usually wanted to see what had happened to him every day. And this is one of the things he told me that happened. One day, their mother and father had to go out to do some errands. They were going to the bakery and the hardware store and the tongue cleaners. And they said, Bucket of Beans and Clarisse, do not go down to the basement this morning while we are out. And do not play with any of our expensive tools down there. And do not do anything you are not supposed to do. Yes, Mommy and Daddy, they said. And their mother and father smiled and said, we have such good children. And as soon as their mother and father left, Bucket of Beans and Clarisse went down into the basement to see what they could find. I know. They weren't supposed to go down there, and they should not have. But in a story like this, usually something happens that you don't expect. And sometimes three or four of those things happen. And this is just the first. They went down into the basement to see what was there. And the first thing they saw when they got down there was their parents' bubble-making machine. Because their mom and dad were in charge of bubbles in the town. Their parents made bubbles for bubble baths, and they made bubbles for birthday parties, and they made bubbles for when people washed their hands with soap. They were quite busy making bubbles and putting them in bubble boxes and bubble bags and bubble wrap too. But of course, making bubbles was a very adult kind of thing to do, and so Bucket of Beans and Clarisse were never allowed to go down into the basement and make bubbles. And they didn't. Until that day. They went down and they looked at the bubble machine. It was a big white square thing with knobs and buttons on it. They stood there and looked at it for a long time. I wonder how it works, said Clarisse. By magic, said Bucket of Beans, and he was right. Because just at that moment, the bubble-making machine spoke to them and said, what size bubbles would you like? And without thinking about it for more than a second, Bucket of Beans said, big ones. How many bubbles would you like? The bubble machine asked, as if it were just having a nice little conversation with a friend, asking if they liked some cookies. A billion, said Clarisse without thinking. When would you like them? Asked the bubble machine. Now, I'm hoping that if you ever meet a bubble machine like this one, you would have the sense not to answer the way Bucket of Beans did, because it caused a lot of trouble. Because when the bubble machine asked, when would you like them? Bucket of Beans shouted, right now! And so he got them. At first, not very many. The bubbles popped out of the top of the machine, one bubble at a time, and Clarisse and Bucket of Beans caught them and held them in their hands, and then popped them. But then they started to come out a little bit faster, and then faster, and pretty soon they were filling up the basement. And Bucket of Beans and Clarisse ran up the basement stairs into the kitchen with the bubbles hot on their trail, bloop, 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 following after them, calling, bloop, hey, put us in boxes where we belong, bloop, or in bags, bloop, or in bubble wrap. Bloop. And I don't know if you have ever done something you weren't supposed to do, but when you realize you shouldn't have done it, one of the things you might want to do is run. And Bucket of Beans and Clarisse ran. They ran out the back door of their house and through their neighbor's yard, and those bubbles poured out of the door after them. Bucket of Beans stopped and he looked back, and he saw their whole house disappearing under a pile of bubbles. Uh-oh, said Clarisse when she looked. I think we've done our final doing. And as soon as she said that, there was a big boom, and up the chimney of the house came the bubble machine, exploding into a million different pieces, and it landed on the street, clanking and sighing with bubbles popping all around. The bubble machine had exploded because it had never been asked to make a billion bubbles before, and it just overdid itself. The bubble board broke and the machine overheated and boom, right up the chimney. "This isn't good," said Bucket of Beans. They stood there looking at it, wondering if they should wait for their parents to come home or just move to another country right then, when who should come down the street but Tom, the rag man. "Rags, rags, bring out your rags," he called out as he pushed a big cart down the middle of the street. Tom the ragman collected broken things and took them back to his yard and let them sit there until they put themselves back together in new ways. He called himself a ragman, and sometimes he collected rags, but mostly he called himself the ragman because it was easier than calling himself something else. "Rags!" he was calling out when he saw a Bucket of Beans and Clarisse standing in the middle of the street looking at their house, which was hidden by a lot of bubbles.
"Whoa," said Tom the ragman. "It looks like somebody asked the bubble machine to make a billion bubbles, and it blew up the chimney and landed in the middle of the street, and now those people are trying to decide if they should move to another country."
And Bucket of Beans and Clarisse didn't say anything. They just looked at Tom the ragman with faces so sad it seemed they might fall right off their heads. What could you say when you have done something your mother and father told you not to do, and now the house was covered in bubbles?
"Well," said Tom the ragman, "tears are good for moving on, but they are not good for staying, because tears that stay don't let you breathe the blue sky and see what comes next. So, we should take a look at what we have. Give me a hand."
And with that, Tom the ragman started to collect all the pieces of the broken bubble machine and put them in his cart, which was also filled with bicycles, flower pots, and spaghetti strainers. And it wasn't much more than 3 or 4 more tears that Bucket of Beans and Clarisse started to help him. They didn't know what he was doing or where it was leading, but he was right. It did seem better than standing around having your faces fall off your heads. When they got all the pieces that they could find in the cart, Tom the ragman lifted up the handles and started to walk down the street, singing to himself and to anybody that would listen.
"Down by the sea where the waves come in, there's a funny little fish with a rainbow fin. It flips and it flops and it flips again. Down by the sea where the waves come in."
"Wait," said Bucket of Beans. "Where are you taking the broken bubble machine? What will happen to our house? And what will we tell our parents? And should we move to another country now or sometime next spring?"
"Well," said Tom the ragman, "too many questions for one boy named Bucket of Beans. But I will tell you that you can live in your house, though you will find bubbles hiding for the next 6 months. And you should tell your parents the truth, since it is always harder to remember what didn't happen than what did. And that the bubble machine isn't a bubble machine anymore, but I'm not sure what it is yet. But you'll get it back when it's ready."
And Bucket of Beans and Clarisse stood and watched him push his cart down the road, and they looked at each other and put their tails between their legs and headed back to their house to try and clean up the bubble stuff before their parents got home. And they almost did. They were very lucky when they were cleaning up because a big wind came up right as they started and blew all the bubbles away from the house over the tops of the trees to another country where they might have run to. And so the only thing they had to clean up were the bubbles inside. At first, they ran around popping bubbles, and then they swept them into the garbage can until the garbage can was full. And then for a while, they even flushed them down the toilet and then used the vacuum cleaner and put some in the one drawer of their chest of drawers that their parents had said they would never look in. And finally, there were only 100 bubbles left and no place to put them. So Bucket of Beans and Clarisse gathered all those bubbles up like a couple of sheepdogs rounding up sheep and put them in a cupboard in the kitchen no one ever used. And just as they did that, the front door opened and into the house came their mother and father. Their mother and father looked around and said,
"Well, well, well, here we are and everything looks neater than when we left."
And they smiled, and Bucket of Beans and Clarisse smiled back. maybe they could have said, yes, but we broke your bubble machine and there are bubbles in the vacuum cleaner and the garbage can and the toilet and some in the cupboard where no one goes. But they didn't. And I can't blame them. They didn't say that. They just smiled. Well, 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 said their parents. We have such good children. Now, you are afraid of what is going to happen. Their mother and father are going down into the basement and see that the bubble machine was missing. And I am afraid too. But they didn't. Because they didn't need to make bubbles. It would be almost a whole month before they had to make bubbles again, since they had recently made some. And there's no point in having too many bubbles, as you already know. So, for a long time, days and days, things went along pretty well, with their mother sighing and their father smiling and saying, we have such good children. And Bucket of Beans and Clarisse every day would walk down the street and over the hill and through the town to the far side of the baseball field, where they would find Tom the Ragman in his front yard filled with broken things being put together again. And they would find Tom sitting out on his front porch, sipping lemonade because it was summer. And they would say, where's the bubble machine? We need it back. And Tom would lift his baseball cap from off his head and scratch the smooth place on top of his head and say, it's not a bubble machine and it's not ready yet, but soon, just when you need it. Bucket of Beans would say, no, we need it today before they find out. And Tom said, if it's not ready, then you don't need it. And he would talk about all sorts of other things and give riddles and tell jokes and show his latest inventions, but he would not talk about bubble machines again. And so it was inevitable, which means it had to happen, because it did. One morning, their father said after breakfast, I think I'll make some of my world-famous sugar cookies with my world-famous sugar cookie pan. Bucket of Beans and Clarisse had never heard of their father's world-famous sugar cookies or his sugar cookie pan, and they said so, and their father said, that is because in all the years you have been living and breathing, I haven't had time, but this morning I have time, and so now I will make some. And he got up from the kitchen table and walked right over to the cupboard that no one ever used. And Bucket of Beans and Clarisse knew they were in a bunch of trouble. No, said Bucket of Beans, we don't like sugar cookies. You'll love mine, said their father. Just make them on any old pan, said Clarisse. Then they wouldn't be world famous, said their father. And before you knew it, he had opened up the cupboard and a blizzard of bubbles came bounding and bouncing out all around their father's head. It seemed like a lot of bubbles. The bubbles were very quiet, although some of them made a noise when they popped, like the plink, plink, plink of piano notes high up on the piano. And their father stood there, watching them fall and bounce around his feet. What have we here? He asked. And things got worse even then, because their mother had gone into the basement, and finally it was the day to make more bubbles. But when she went into the basement, there was not a bubble maker to be found, just a space where the bubble maker used to be. Where is the bubble maker? She asked. She came running up the stairs and looked in the kitchen and saw her husband standing there with bubbles at his feet and some on his shoulders and one balancing on the tip of his nose. And it got very quiet indeed, very quiet. Bucket of Beans looked at Clarisse, and Clarisse looked at Bucket of Beans, and their mother and father looked at each other, and nobody said anything. There is a moment, right after things have gone very wrong, when it is not quite clear how people will behave. Will they jump up and down? Will they do somersaults? Will they laugh? Will they cry? Will they stand on a chair and sing a song from some old movie? You never know. It depends on a lot of different things, including how much they had for breakfast and if somebody gave them a birthday cake when they were six. But sooner or later, they will have to decide how they are going to act when things go wrong. But in that moment, everyone's just waiting, balancing on a teeter-totter, wondering which way they will go. And that is what Clarisse and Bucket of Beans and their mother and father did for a very long time. Everybody looked at each other. It was like the whole town around the bend was holding its breath. And then both of their parents looked at each other and then at Bucket of Beans and Clarisse and said exactly at the same moment together, "Why don't you tell us what happened?" And something sighed and breathed. And Tom the Ragman, sitting on his front porch, looking at the broken bubble machine, knew what to do. So he tied his sneakers and got up. And Bucket of Beans explained how they went down into the basement, even when they weren't supposed to, and telling the bubble machine to make a billion bubbles right now, and running away from the bubbles that were chasing them, and the bubble machine exploding, and how bad they felt, and then there was a knock on the door. And they answered it. And there stood Tom the Ragman in his cart. And in his cart was something that looked very much like the bubble machine, although there were some bicycle handlebars on it, and it was painted a bright green. "Hello, hello, hello," he said. "I have come to visit you with something that has died and been reborn, different than before, not better or worse, but definitely different." And he pushed the buttons and turned the knobs, and the machine clanked and whirred, and the hole opened that bubbles came out of, but instead of a bubble, out came a large red balloon in the shape of a kangaroo. And then another balloon in the shape of a comet, and two more, one in the shape of a hippopotamus, and one that looked a little like a piece of chocolate cake. And Tom the Ragman gave one to everyone standing there. Bucket of Beans hugged his balloon, and Clarisse hugged hers, and their father and mother said, "Better than before, better than before." And maybe it was. And Bucket of Beans and Clarisse promised to never run the balloon machine. And they didn't. And my town around the bend has plenty of balloons now, but very few bubbles at all. Although someday, if you open up a cupboard, some might bounce out. And you will know where they're from. And if that's not true, it should be.